Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are student from Alauddin Makassar State Islamic University. This video was made to complete one of group assignment in America Literature course. We of the group of A, group of 3 members. First of all, let's thanks to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, the great and the most merciful, who has been giving us things and blessings so we can be here join this meeting. Okay, I'm Mulandari. Here I will get the presentation of the video. In this material, talk about the modern source story. On this ocean of friends who want to download this material, please check link below the description. But before I discuss, we will introduce ourselves. I'm Mulandari as moderator. The next member is Aprilia Wahyuningrum, the first speaker, and Widya Wiswara will be the second speaker. Alright guys, I invite April to present the first speaker. April, time is yours.
Emergence of the modern short story. The 19th century. The modern short story emerged almost simultaneously in Germany, the United States, France, and Russia. In Germany, there had been relatively little difference between the stories of the late 18th century and those in the older tradition of Boccaccio. In 1795, Goethe contributed a set of stories to Friedrich Schiller's journal, Die Horen, that were obviously created with the Decameron in mind. Significantly, Goethe didn't call them short stories, although the term was available to him. Rather, he talked of them as entertainments for German travelers. But a new type of short fiction was near at hand, a type that accepted some of the realistic properties of popular journalism. In 1827, 32 years after publishing his own entertainments, Goethe commented on the difference between the newly emergent story and the older kind. Respect for the story. In at least one way, 19th century America resembled 16th century Italy. There was an abundance of second and third-rate short stories, and yet respect for the form grew substantially, and most of the great artists of the century were actively participating in its development. James, Howells, Harte, Twain, Melville, and Hawthorne all. But the foremost American critic of the short story was Edgar Allan Poe, himself a creator of influential impressionist techniques. Poe believed that the definitive characteristic of the short story was its unity of effect. The development and rise of the American short story in the 19th century was the result of simple market forces. Because urban populations in America were so unstable, workers moving from city to city as new lands and employment opportunities arose, newspapers found that serializing novels was bad business. Advertisement space was worthless alongside a chapter from a novel that no one lived in town long enough to read. British novelists like Dickens and Trollope published their novels first in serial form, and then collected the chapters together to sell as a book. American novelists had very few venues for serialization, which is why the shape of the American literary novel differs so radically from its British counterpart. Chapters from serialized novels read like episodes of soap operas. Each chapter opens with a crisis that is soon resolved and closes with the introduction of a new crisis or cliffhanger, which will be resolved at the beginning of the next installment. Not so with the American novel, think Moby Dick or Huckleberry Finn. With no periodical market for the novel in the US, writers of fiction in the first half of the 19th century borrow the form of the short tale from German authors such as Wilhelm Kleist and E.T.A. Hoffmann and altered the form to suit American newspapers. The result was the literary form we now know as the short story. What we now know as a literary form, however, was originally no more high art than is pop music today. Short stories were commercial products written for newspapers and magazines by writers who were trying to make a living at it. Poe tried to elevate the short story to the condition of art, and Hawthorne produced a few volumes. Thus, Melville's Piazza Tales and The Little Busybody, Washington Irving wrote the Knickerbocker Tales. For the most part, however, the short story was a more short entertainment akin to a sitcom or how long drama on the television.
Okay, thank you, April. The next material is going to present by Widya Wiswara.
The history of the novel is short, covering only if you read its invention from rehearsal, a period of 200 years. The history, the short story, through its pieces of myth and legend, fable and parable, anecdote and pictorial essay, sketch, and even down to what the crudest provincial reporter calls a good story can be measured. The account in Genesis of the conflict between Cain and Abel is a short story. The parable of the prodigal son is a short story and in itself a masterpiece of compression for all time.
Examples of an art that was already old, civilized, and highly developed some thousands of years before the Fogue of Pamela.
Origins, Gogol and Poe. Nikolai Vasilievich Gogol was born at Sorosinsky in Russia in 1819. Exactly the same year Edgar Allan Poe was born in Baltimore. Gogol was educated at Tennyson, Poe at Stoke Newington in England. Gogol died in 1852, Poe in 1849. And from this, the short lives may be said to flow the twin streams of the modern short story.
The praise I think it was Gorky's we all spring from Gogol's overcoat is on of with truth, for Gogol is something more than the father of the modern short story in all its manifestation of poetic realism, and of the excellent short story in particular, which in its pictorial accuracy and emotional liveliness seems today as modern as ever. Gogol marks the switch over from romanticism to the thing which, for want of a better expression, we still call realism. He marks the beginning of the wider application of visual writing, of vivid objectivity, or that particular faith in indigenous material which is today's strike of the American short story, can the absence of which brought it to such pastoral levels 30 years ago. Gogol is the father of all readers who say, "I believe the lives of ordinary human folk, rich or poor, adventurous or parochial, good or depraved, dull or exciting, constitute the only vein of material our reader need ever forsake or work." Gogol, like all good readers, since looked outside his back door entirely the that of his mother's farm at Dikanka and save a life that clashed within itself with such remarkably diverse virility that there was no need to look further.
Of this kind of reader, Poe was a remarkable example. Through his stories runs this transmissible something. It's clearly like result of a deep complex physical state. Poe, like Lawrence, was a sick man, so that the subsequent effect in story after story is that of high emotional and nervous tension. The specs are darkly dyed with morbidity. The echoes are those of souls beating their hands on the walls of madhouses.
Okay, thank you, Widya. Point finally, Is this the America's story? Has its own unique history and patterns of development. This history and development is not the same as the of the American novel, which is still a thriving medium and a medium with the wide range of aesthetic intent. The American story, as a popular form, is descendants. The story art form survivors of in the literary fringes of the culture. Alright, guys, I think that's all for our presentation today. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.